Welcome to another Fleet Ops audio commentary, brought to you today by Clint Set and special guest commentator Primogenia.
Hello, everybody.
We've got a nice little 1v1 on a map that Stardust made quite a while ago called It's At Your Doorstep. A little different, something other than Duel 2. So as we get started, Primi, why don't you let us know what the players are doing?
Alrighty. Well, here in the top left, we have Blue Arash as Klingons. And I'm going to let you call the avatar. I believe that is a Martok.
Tok Roja. Yep, got the beam ready to go there. Arash wanted to practice up on his Klingon. He usually plays Borg, so should be fun. Should have some interesting strategies there. What's going on at the bottom?
Well, we've got Boggs down here is the White Federation. Not going to be able to know his avatar yet, but it could really go either way. He definitely doesn't like to do the normal Mason spam, so we could see either avatar very easily.
Yeah, I would love to see some Canaverals, maybe just some neat stuff like that. And they actually do quite well against Klingon, so you never know what we'll see. Nice Kabej start from Arash.
Might definitely see some unusual stuff from Boggs here. I think it should be interesting to see, you know, Boggs is known as a very experienced Klingon player. It's his main race, and we're going to see how that affects his ability to react to what he's going to know his opponent is going to be capable of.
Both players, I believe, have never played on this map before. Just to give you a little tour, you've got main base moons that are actually quite far away from the star base, so no real coverage there, much like Duel 2. You got a little expansion, Dilithium Moon, that's fairly close by. But if you go a little further out into the corners, you've got a full moon pair. So definitely kind of a challenge to get that full moon pair if you are not either sneaky or fast. We see that Arash is moving down there, so sneaky there. And then there's a tri-moon right in the middle. So it's a good place to kind of hold out if you want that extra try. And not too much going on here. I'm really surprised Arash is going to sneak down in the bottom here. Totally going to get away with it, though.
No, it looks like we are going to see Arisener here.
Yeah, and he's actually expanding to that closer Dilithium Moon. So we probably will see 2 yards fairly close together. That's kind of cool.
Yeah, I like the setup here. You know, you can relatively easily grab onto that single Dilithium Moon for an expansion, but you know, you're really going to have to prepare yourself to be able to move out further to the less protected further expansion if you really want to keep your resources balanced.
Battle Yard coming up here on the bottom, just a stone's throw away from this Antares Yard. And if you look at Boggs, he's got a nice little platform covering his try. He's got his yard kind of covering his main Dilithium, and he built the station far enough back that the guns ought to cover it. Whereas if you look at Arash, his stations are far enough away that the starbase guns really won't cover it. So a little difference in playstyle. We'll see how that works for them. Do you think double yard Intrepids?
I don't know. Might see someone soon. Double yard Intrepid's really not going to be that bad to start off with.
Charg! Wow. Interesting move by Arash there. I mean, the Charg, it does have fast-tracking computers, so not a bad counter against the Intrepid, but man, oh man, they tend to miss, so that should be kind of interesting. No Starfleet science coming up. You know, Monsoon are not that bad against Charg, really. Since the torpedo just sends.
Yeah, I'm gonna see a little rating here. Not gonna get any kills. It's gonna be a bit of an annoyance. I think the main difference here is Boggs has a. It is defended, but he only has the dilithium expansion, whereas Arash has access to a full expansion here. So Arash, a little bit ahead on the economy right now.
Well, yeah, I mean, I will agree that he'll be in a good position, but if you notice, Boggs already has miners on it, and Arash has only got one miner. I mean, he is sending a couple down. Looks like he took his main dilithium miners and moved them down. I think that might hurt his dilithium, but, you know, we'll see. Decloak happening and going after that miner. Char getting on some in on the action here. Oh, are they gonna get that miner? I don't think so. Oh, Char hit. Oh, got it.
Close. Oh, got it. Very nice.
Charg, just a great damage dealer when that torpedo hits. And he's getting good luck with it, too. Interesting that the Intrepids are targeting the Charg.
Well, the Charg is going to do more damage than the Kabej.
Yeah, and... You know, I guess in a way, Arash comes out ahead there, and then he did get them, did get him to stop building that platform. Though I think he's just going to turn around and build it again.
Yeah, he's just going to wait a couple seconds and.
You know, I've looked. I don't think that Boggs knows about this expansion in the bottom. Did you see a scout going around? I didn't see a scout.
No, his scout's just kind of up there in the top. I don't think he has any idea that this is down here.
He's going to get suspicious pretty soon, I think.
Yeah. Arash might, you know, take his time between attacks, you know, so he's not giving anything away, but I don't know if it's really going to be worth it for that lost time.
We'll see if the Intrepid guard this platform going up. Looks like they're going to try to. Four Intrepid against four Klingon ships, they might be able to stop this platform again.
No, they're certainly going to try.
They're not going to get a kill here.
Not taking any chances. Rash being careful to have his ships moving in the direction of his main as he cloaks out.
Yep, there. Got out. The platform will start any second now. I think Hogs just wants to have this covered and has the science up, has the cloak detect. Yeah. Another scout.
Yeah, I think Boggs has figured out what's going on down here. And this Klingon ship's going to be just out of range of that ping. Yeah,
but Char Kadouche, just a good all-around move. Well, you know what? He hasn't scouted it yet, and this is the cool thing that happens when you play with a new map. You don't always know where things are at. Probably has no idea that Arash would be this ballsy. Oh, now
definitely
the Intrepids
not.
Are going out there. Yeah, he's got a suspicion. Maybe. Yeah.
No, I think he saw that yard. Yeah.
Oh, and the Charg is up.
Rash kind of trying to pull back and cloak there, but I'm pretty sure Boggs saw that.
Starfleet Command.
Yeah, Boggs
going
is going to. Yeah, he's going to need those warpins. He's going to need a transition out of these short range ships very soon. His Intrepid and Monsoons are just not going to do very well, I don't think, against what Rash is fielding.
Yeah, and we see the Kadouche coming out. All around great ship, and Arash is going for another expansion. And he's got Boggs kind of bottled up. He's going to take some of his eyes away from him in a second here. Let's see if he goes for the steal. He does go for the steal. Will his shields get there? Okay, got the shields up. Now Boggs has to choose between scouting or having his cloak detect available for his fleet. Great all-around play here. These guys could even stop that Starfleet command. It's risky. I think that's what they're gonna do.
I don't see. Does Arash have a scout there?
He moved his scout away.
Okay, I see that. Oh wow, they're gonna get right in there.
Does stop it, and that's a good deal of time saved for them. Oh, are they going to kill this scout?
It doesn't quite have the energy for the cloak detect.
Oh, lucky guys, and they got a monsoon on the way.
Oh, it's Chase. I think he's going
to
set it off here in a second.
Oh, that charg is going to die. Oh, buddy.
Yep, there goes the ping.
Oh, somehow, magically... Oh!
Really good ping there.
Yeah, and, wow, Arash gets it away.
Arash's ships are... Okay, there we go.
Oh, just killing these monsoons. Yeah, his kabedge aren't moving. But, look at that. Got a couple of good monsoon kills.
Kabedge barely getting away.
Yeah, just pulling
ships getting
back.
Yeah, both players get some... Both players getting some good kills here.
Kaduj doing their thing, and... Ooh, these Intrepids are in for some hurt.
Yeah, with this Kaduj here, Boggs really needs to pull back.
Boggs
well,
opted for the sensor platform.
Double yarding monsoons now.
Will he catch the scout? Oh, he's gonna get the scout.
With that sensor platform there, it'll give him a little more mobility with his scouting.
Oh, Proxy Torp taking out the Kabedge. Oh,
Charge going up too.
Now tides turned a little bit.
Oh, but look at this. Arash has both full expansions under his control.
He does indeed. Any research stations? No research stations yet, so sticking with... Oh, there it is, right in the bottom. Does have the field research, so expect to see maybe the heavy disruptor. Starfleet Command going up again. Oh, and Boggs just going to set up that platform.
He's just going to maybe
right
walk these platforms over towards this expansion a bit. Really walling off this expansion if he makes that a sensor platform. And it looks like Arash is going to maybe try to stop this.
Oh, and he's going to get caught by this. Oh, but might kill this Intrepid.
And scout getting out there a little far.
Yeah, monsoon going down. Another monsoon's gonna take some serious fire. Platform's gonna make it up though. Oh,
and so will Starfleet Command.
Yeah, this is slowly turning into Boggs' favor here. He can take the losses.
Kaduj really doing some damage here though.
But he's not getting the kill. Target that platform and probably kill it right now if he fires on it.
It's upgrading.
Yeah.
There's
a platform. Kabedge going out. Oh, man. Another cloak detect going off.
Boggs is really pushing on this expansion here. Rash still managing to get several ships out. But wow, these guys are really going at it for this expansion here.
Yeah, the cloak detect really making a difference.
Yeah, Boggs, several cloak detects going off just here in the past couple minutes.
Oh, and...
There we go.
Well, interesting game here. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you later.
See you next time.